Good morning to you, man. George Page coming to you live on YouTube. Now, this lady before you is one Miss Candy Canary. And Miss Canary was a female bodybuilder. She last time she competed was in 2007. Now, before then, she was born in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, September the 10th of 1974. Now, she grew up in Oklahoma, where she went to high school, and she was a track. She competed in track and was also a long-distance runner. Now, in 92, after she graduated from high school, she joined into the United States Air Force, following a family tradition started by her grandfather and her father. Now, during her time in the Air Force, she was what you call a flight medic. So whenever airmen or certain other military members were injured, she was there to tend to them. While during her time in the United States Air Force, she was also a recruiter, where she was cited. She won was awarded with citations and also other awards for her job as a recruiter. Now during that time, she was dipping into the sport of bodybuilding, and she competed her first show in 2004, which was the Lone Star Classic. She was one of three heavyweights, but she came in third. The problem was she still had some issues, a little water depletion and some other problems she needed to tweak and work on. But Candy went back to the drawing board. Around 2004, she got into a bad accident, which forced her out of the military by medical discharge. So while she was rehabbing doing her medical discharge, she started really working on her bodybuilding and her dieting and nutrition and really working up and trying to figure out where, to develop her body to a better standard. Now, she came back to bodybuilding in 2006, where she competed at the Emerald Cup, which is a competition that's done often, usually a year-end NPC competition that's done in Oregon State. Now, quite a few female bodybuilders came from that competition, such as the late Shady Biddy, Anne-Marie Mendoza, and I forget somebody else. There's a couple I can't think of off my head, but quite a few have came from that show and gone on to become IFBB pros. And then later in that same year, she competed at the USA Championships, but she took seventh place. So she came back the following year, 2007, competed at the USA Championships, and took fourth place. Now, the thing about Mrs. Beattie and her life was that at the time she was studying to become a minister. And also she was training for the USA Championships, she was also planning on doing some missionary work in Africa and around Central Asia. Now, before she started her career, she was married previously and she had two sons. But that marriage ended after a few years. And while she was, at the time she was competing in 2007, in bodybuilding, she was engaged and she was ready to be married. After that, as she was doing her missionary work, she was married, and she also decided to leave bodybuilding because the calling of God was more important than the calling of the iron. Miss Beattie for a good while was doing missionary work and also being a minister of her own church. From information I got from some sources here and there, that Miss Canary and her husband, her second husband, got a divorce, and there were some stories that she also has some miscarriages. Now she's no longer married, and she's taking care of her sons are probably, they were young boys when she competed, and they're probably a teenager or grown man by now. Well, Candy Canary was she was a phenomenon. She was a very, like I said, if you look at her, she's a very attractive woman. She has amazing muscle development. She reminded me of a bodybuilder named Tina Lockwood. Tina Lockwood was amazing. Huge female bodybuilder. Very muscular. But also, she had very, she has very feminine, face. And she also had a very, most people talk about, say about female bodybuilders, how their voices are deep from taking roids. But if you ever saw a video with Candy, when she speak, her voice was very feminine. Same thing with Tina Lockwood. But, you know, it was just, she did a lot of videos and quite a few pictures and photos during her time as a female bodybuilder. She was very, like I said, by looks, she was very photogenic. And this was something that the IFBB NBC like, a female bodybuilder that fit the idea of what they want, the muscle and the beauty. And that's what Canary had. But it was kind of disappointing that she decided to walk away from the sport to focus on more on her godly purpose in life, and that was to minister to the people. But that's how it happens sometimes. There's quite a few bodybuilders that had with great potential. They've become great legends in the sport, but they walked away for some other reason, whether it's personal or financial, or just sometimes it wasn't in the heart for them anymore. But Canary was very amazing. I think, like I said, this picture here, this is what I call a half crab pose, and I think that's the most sexy pose that a female bodybuilder can do. But like I said, maybe someday, you know, down the line, she might come back. Sometimes it happens. Sometimes I know some bodybuilders been out of work, you know, from the sport maybe a few years. They come back and just for the hell of it, just to come back and compete because of the athlete's nature of them they have. Well, it's your man, George Page. Like, subscribe. Don't subscribe. I'm out.